think it was Red Smith who said, writing's easy. All you have to do is sit in front of a typewriter and open a vein. I'm really not sure I can write this book. I know where my characters come from. The problem is, I don't know where they're going. And without an ending, But there was a beginning. It was just over a year ago. 13 months, 3 weeks, 4 days, for those who are keeping track. The simple truth is, it's not every day you meet someone like Claire. I was waiting for my third novel to come out, but I wasn't antsy. Or should I be? The early notices were favorable, and McCready, the guy in charge of marketing at my publishing house, had promised me a decent ad campaign. We even reached a compromise on the cover. This is Jack Hollander. Let me speak to McCready.
I'm sorry, Mr. Hollander. Mr. McCready is no longer with the firm.
Then let me speak to who's ever in charge of marketing.
Oh, that would be Miss Claire Fielding, but I'm afraid she's not in just now.
Well, I'd like to make an appointment with Miss Claire Fielding.
For a meeting.
What about my,
Here's my card. If you, I work right across the street. If you'll call my secretary, he can give you my insurance. Anything else you need. I'm really sorry.
What about my bumper?
Lead a charmed life.
It has its moments.
Sure. Do you mind if we get out of here and go for a walk?
I have a better idea. Let's have lunch.
Miss Fielding.
Roger, this is Mr. Hollander.
Pleased to meet you.
How do you do?
Come along, I have your table.
We'll have a bottle of the
usual?
Yes. It's my favorite wine.
Thank you. I'll bring your wine right over.
Do you mind if I get right to the point?
You don't like the cover.
Right.
I think it's a very strong cover.
For a different book. Look. I thought McCready and I had come to an agreement.
Oh, well, if you did, I'm sorry about that. But it doesn't change my opinion any. Jack, McCready was fired because of a poor sales record. I was brought in to improve that record.
I have a feeling you will.
It's my job. It's what I do well. You know, there's always an optimum way to sell a book, no matter what it's about. It requires a strong promotional campaign and a cover
that feels like a Turkish bath.
That isn't what I was gonna say.
Well, you can get a sunburn from that cover, and you know it. Why don't you tell me, what you thought of the book?
I thought the excerpts were excellent. Mm-hmm. And I thought that the synopsis had a really
wonderful... Wait a second. Wait. The synopsis?
I didn't have time to read the book,
That
Jack.
Is unbelievable.
We were going
you
to miss the release
book?
Date.
How can you do a promotional campaign
Jack,
for a book if you don't read the book?
Jack,
campaign on
Jack,
the book.
You and I both want the same thing for this book we wanted to sell. If you give me a chance... To begin with, I want to put you on some talk shows. I thought you'd like that one.
You might be in for a surprise.
I can hardly wait.
When's Daddy coming home?
Soon. He's doing rounds tonight.
Hey, he's cute.
I'm not so sure cute is the word I'd use.
He's cute. You know, he reminds me of Mr. Scoville.
Your math teacher?
He's such a hunk.
Do you have a crush on Mr. Scoville?
No, Mom, he's too old. I have a crush on Bobby Yermak. He sits in front of me in homeroom.
Have I ever met him?
Mm-mm.
Would you like to invite him over?
Mother, I barely said two words to him. I'd die if he knew I liked him.
Come here. You know what? I had a crush on your father. For an entire year before I ever even got the nerve to talk to him.
He did?
I did. Going in all the major newspapers.
It'll be fine. With a few changes.
I read your book last night, and I really think we could have a bestseller on our hands. If it's marketed properly. Jack, I'm willing to work with you if you're willing to work with me.
Did you like the book?
Very much.
And we can work together.
Good. I hope you're not doing anything next Thursday or Friday.
I'm training for the Alcatraz race. It's a mile and a half swim across the bay.
Have you ever done this before?
Don't worry. If I don't make it, it'll help the sales of the book.
Okay, here's the deal. Sacramento, the Michael Jackson show.
Michael Jackson show, huh?
I will send a car for you.
My favorite on-the-air intellectual.
This man has won 7 Emmys. He really does his homework. He asks some very tough questions, so you better be ready for him.
I think that he better be ready for me.
His show has just been picked up nationally. We're talking about a huge audience with lots of women, so do remember that when you look into the camera, will you?
I will try.
What he is a little Eric. We could be talking Book of the Month Club here.
So?
So he's like the characters in his books, totally unpredictable.
Ben, what are you saying? What are you saying, Benny?
Claire, what I'm saying is that he's not exactly Michael Jackson's kind of guy.
You the chauffeur?
The babysitter. Everyone at Dunham is going to be watching this show, so somebody had to go along and make sure you didn't punch out Michael Jackson. Any objections?
None so far.
Good. Then let's go.
Thank you. tell me, how does your husband feel about your overnights?
It's part of my job.
You know, if you were my wife, I wouldn't let you out of my sight.
Well, it's a good thing I'm not your wife, isn't it?
What does your husband do?
He's a cardiologist. Shouldn't we be discussing your television debut?
What's there to discuss? I'm supposed to smile at all the ladies and wave hello to my mom back in New York.
What are you going to say about the book?
The book? I'll make the point that equality in the bedroom is like equality in politics. It kills the instincts to participate.
Maybe you should just smile at the ladies and wave to your mom back in New York.
Well, now, Jack, your novel seems to say
Ready
that we're all going to end up getting divorced.
It's more than likely.
That's sort of sad when you think of it.
It's not as sad as couples staying together out of fear of change.
Take one.
Jack, do you think people really want to read books with such a negative point of view?
I hope so.
Yes, I suppose you do. You know, I must say, I find this cover rather risque for such an important or serious work.
Well, look, if you're trying to get me to defend that cover...
Yes.
Well, you can forget it.
Why?
Well, I don't happen to like it.
Well, what's it doing on your book?
Well, you'd have to ask the woman in charge of marketing.
Right, and what's her explanation?
She doesn't have one.
She doesn't have one?
No, you see, she decided on the book cover before she read the book.
I love it. You know, we're reaching a stage, I think, and I'd like you to take a good look at this cover. We're reaching a stage where they're going to be designing the covers before they even write the stories. Jack, I have a feeling that perhaps she should write your next book. I'd like to thank Jack Hollander for joining us and for teaching us a little bit about book publishing.
Keep the change.
Telephone call for Mr. Warren. Call for Mr. Warren.
Claire! Fielding?
Wait a second, Fielding.
You have a lot of nerve, Mr. Hollander.
Does that surprise you?
No, it doesn't surprise me. What surprises me is that you didn't come out and name names. You didn't say Claire Fielding.
Well,
is the one
I just
who
didn't have time to. Mr. Jackson cut to a commercial.
Well, this must be my lucky day.
Well, it must be.
You know, you have to be the most insensitive, egotistical, self-involved.
Does that mean you won't have dinner with me? Does that mean you won't have dinner with me?
It's a 3-on-2. Ames passes to McGregor. They're down the ice.
Who is it?
Jack Hollander. I've got to talk with you.
At 1 o'clock in the morning?
I've come to apologize.
Excuse me, wait a minute. I don't think I understood you. I thought you said you came to apologize.
I did.
So that'd be a good one. All right, I'm listening.
Face to face.
Nice room.
Who do you know?
Well, do make yourself at home.
Thank you.
Look, Claire, I had no intention of hurting you. I want you to know that.
Hey, it's okay. Don't worry about it. I'm over it.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not. Look, Claire, I really am sorry.
Apology accepted.
Good. Now, what about your apology?
Excuse me?
Your apology for the way you zoomed off back there, leaving me stranded in the parking lot.
You're lucky I didn't run over you.
I can't believe you'd do that.
You have no idea what I'm capable of doing.
That's true. But I'd like to find out.
I think you'd better leave. Now.
You really want me to?
Yes.
European styling foam.
Designed to hold your hair in any style with softness.
Ooh, Alberto Mousse. Feel that softness in your style.
Ooh, Alberto.
When you go on vacation, criminals go to work. So don't carry cash. Carry American Express traveler's checks.
Don't leave home without them.
Give a little nibble, give a little nibble.
Wendy's asks, before you eat your next hamburger, any hamburger, taste the meat.
Give a little nibble.
Is it dry and chewy, or hot and juicy? Is it bland, or is it tasty?
Give a little nibble.
No other hamburger has Wendy's hot and juicy taste. The more you nibble others, the more you'll love Wendy's.
Created new extra strength Bengay sports balm, the sports medicine with something extra. Rub it on when you warm up to help make your muscles more limber and relaxed, and use it after a hard workout to relieve muscle soreness. Introducing extra strength Bengay sports balm, the sports medicine with the extra you need.
Return to the CBS Tuesday movie, The Other Lover.
Honey, it's Mom. How are you this morning? Is everything okay? Oh, yeah. Oh, that's good. Honey, is Daddy home? Oh, all right. No. I'll try and reach him later at the office. Okay, what? I missed you too, honey. Okay, you have a good day. All right, I love you. Bye-bye. Sorry. I had to make some calls.
Do you have to rush off?
Oh, I told Danny I'd be in today. Coffee. Just coffee, please.
Fine, thank you.
I spoke to my daughter.
Yeah? How is she?
She's fine.
Good.
Maggie, my little one, she's very excited. Allison is taking her to her first slumber party.
Claire, did you talk with your husband?
No. He had to leave for the hospital early this morning. He's on call tonight.
Must be rough being married to a doctor.
Well, you learn to make sacrifices. I wanted a stiff drink at 8 o'clock in the morning.
I can't.
Was it in a hotel coffee shop?
No. Claire, I want you to know something. The only married women I know are in my books. Now, last night was wonderful. No, it was more than wonderful.
Can we just go, please? Can we just go? Jack, I have been married for 13 years. I have never been unfaithful to my husband.
I know that. Maybe we should forget that last night ever happened.
Can you? Can you just forget it? Because I can't. The worst part of it is I don't even want to. That's the part I...
There's an old inn up the coast. We could have dinner. We could spend the night.
Jack, it's out of the question. I have two children at home. I have a husband. I can't go anywhere with you. Do you understand that? I want to go home.
Okay. Let's go.
If I go with you, I'll pay for it later.
And if you don't go?
You drive.
They're making the room up now. Exactly how long will it be?
I'll have him out of there in 5 minutes.
You prefer a particular side of the bed?
Well, I was sort of hoping that we'd both end up in the middle.
Right. Thanks.
Thanks. Thanks for what?
I'm trying to make it easier for me.
I'm trying to make it easier for both of us.
Process takes place over a period of time, varying between 6 months and 2 years, depending on the type. Contained within these walls are over 200 casks of fine red wine and dessert wine. The casks are made out of redwood and oak. The wood allows the wine to breathe and to mellow. This slowly allows the wine to take on the subtle and complex characteristics for which our label is renowned. Now, follow me, we'll be going
to... Jack, we're supposed to be tasting the wine.
I am. Wait, wait. One Chardonnay.
Do I have any choice?
Absolutely not. This one is yours. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And this one is mine.
I'm going on a mission of mercy. You serve me a drink.
Have you?
More.
about some coffee?
How about going back to the room?
Not a pretty story.
Well, I didn't expect it to be.
The high point was my marriage.
And the low point was?
My marriage.
I didn't even know you were married.
Yes. When I was 2 and 20.
How long did it last?
3 years. I was writing, she was working.
She supported you?
Yeah. She was real sweet.
So what went wrong?
I started to punish her for marrying a bum.
You about the ad campaign.
We're gonna have to bring someone else into the practice. The three of us just cannot continue at this pace.
Daddy, why don't you get a woman doctor?
I will. As soon as you graduate from medical school.
Oh, seems like your father has big plans for you.
What about me? You can't even stand the sight of blood.
You're just gonna have to settle for chief of staff. By the way, did you talk to Harvey?
Maggie, don't eat out of your sister's plate, please. Yes, I asked him to file an extension on the quarterly taxes. Everything is piling up at the office. Everyone's frantic down there. I just don't have time right now.
They're always frantic. Maggie, what'd your mother just tell you?
Can we go watch TV?
Sure. As soon as you finish your homework.
Now we gotta finish those evaluations tonight. You need any help?
No. I'll do fine.
Mom. Remember when you thought these were dumb-looking earrings? And, like, you were so wrong. Well, you're not always. I mean, okay, like when you told me about Stay Free and how you can really count on it to protect even on kind of heavy days. Well, you were... Mom, you were right. Did I say that?
Stay Free Protection, a confidence you'll share. Now in new shaped, too.
If you get painful headaches, you should know that recently, people like you nationwide took part in the largest headache test ever. Extra strength Tylenol against ibuprofen. Conclusion? Not even twice the initial recommended dose of ibuprofen is more effective than extra strength Tylenol. And something else. Tylenol doesn't irritate your stomach the way ibuprofen can, if nothing is more effective for headaches. And Tylenol is gentler to your stomach. Shouldn't your choice be Tylenol?
You're listening to Children of Japan. This joyous and beautiful sound comes to you from Delta Airlines, because Delta is flying to Tokyo, gateway to the Orient. Come with us to a land steeped in tradition, yet as modern as tomorrow. We'll fly you to the gracious charm of the Far East with all the comfort of the familiar West. Delta to Japan.
Delta, get you there. We get you there with care.
After 7 days of treatment with iodine, this cut still hasn't healed. The same is true for the leading antiseptic liquid, the leading antiseptic spray. In fact, none of them help heal as fast as the number one doctor-recommended first aid treatment, Neosporin. Clinical testing shows that Neosporin helps wounds heal faster because its triple antibiotic formula kills bacteria that can cause infection. Neosporin, for faster healing, it's the one.
We will return to The Other Lover, starring Jack Scalia. Friday, Dallas.
You're about to find out what real power can do.
The company's being dissolved.
I swear to God, I'll kill you.
What has become of this family?
In the shadow of disaster and on Falcon Crest, betrayal.
You walked out without even a glance back.
Blackmail and the legacy of revenge. Friday. Triumph and despair. Cagney and Lacey. The riveting season climax starts Monday.
This is CBS.
Otasco has taken big bucks off every mower. Otasco's best value, the 20-inch long life, just $169.99. And this long life's only $99.99. And they'll assemble, service, and test start your mower free. Now, who else does that anymore? Of course, there's one mower they don't have. Mostly because it's a pain to keep on the showroom floor.
I love dinner parties.
You love dinner. Should Country Crock go here?
All that rich buttery taste.
Or with the green beans.
Green beans?
You love green beans.
Must have been your first husband.
You are my first husband.
Shed spread Country Crock. Rich buttery taste, fewer calories than regular margarine, and no cholesterol.
We're out of shed spread Country Crock.
Well, here's something new. Country Crock and Mini Crock.
Same rich buttery taste?
Mm-hmm, and a third fewer calories, too.
Hey, that's two good reasons to eat Country Crock.
In two adorable new Mini Crocks.
Looks like they were made for each other.
Uh-huh, another perfect couple. Uh-huh.
The latest chapter in the PTL story, tonight at 10 o'clock.
We now return to Lindsay Wagner in The Other Lover.
I think it's such a good idea honoring six writers at the same party.
Well, this way, none of you can complain about preferential treatment, can you? Danny, is everyone here now?
Yeah, everybody except Jack Holland.
Yeah.
But it's early yet.
Are you sure he knew what time you were supposed to be here?
Claire, he's gonna be here. Have you ever known a writer to miss one of these things?
That's right, Dan.
I wasn't sure you were coming.
I wouldn't have. Except I knew you'd be here. Claire. I haven't felt this good in such a long time.
Oh.
In fact. I can't remember ever.
I've tried so hard not to think about you all week. That's why I had Danny call you about the party. I knew what would happen if I heard your voice.
What? What? What would happen?
I would probably start babbling like some lovesick teenager or something.
It's okay.
What are we gonna do?
I don't know. How much time do we have?
Jack.
What?
Karen.
Where then?
Los Angeles, next week.
What's in L.A.?
The morning show. And me.
I can't wait that long.
Oh.
What about tomorrow night?
Oh, I have a late meeting tomorrow night.
So?
Oh, so I'll call you when it's over.
Okay.
Make sure Allison gets the one without the lettuce, okay?
Good luck on your history test.
Oh, thanks, Dad.
I'm late.
Hey, you know, you look gorgeous this morning.
Happy to see you too.
What are you doing home?
The point of owning my own restaurant is that I don't have to go to work every night, okay?
Oh, I see.
Actually, I ran into a friend of yours.
Who?
Lisa. She's across the hall talking to Ginny. Come on, let's go.
Waiting for a phone call.
So you're just gonna sit there and wait for the phone to ring?
It's an important phone call.
Well, then you better stay right next to the phone.
Sal! Sal, give me the phone, Sal.
What? It'll ring over here.
Jack, you and I were friends before we were lovers. Friends again?
Yeah. Friends. Yeah. Where have you been?
I hope it's not too late.
It's never too late.
I was here a little earlier.
You were? Oh, I was next door talking with my friend Sal.
Yeah, I know. Well, I came upstairs. You weren't here. And then I heard you laughing next door, so...
And you, saw me talking with Lisa. She's just a good friend.
Nothing more?
Well, she used to be. Until I met you. Why do you think I dragged this phone all the way across the hall?
Jack.
I thought you were supposed to call me the minute you were finished with your meeting.
It was getting so late.
And?
I just wanted to get here.
Well, you're here.
Delicious. How was your fettuccine?
Oh, I love the fettuccine here. You know that. I always eat too much when we come here. Would you like to go to a movie?
Oh, I don't care. Sure, sure.
Anything in particular you'd like to see? Peter, if you don't want to go, it's all right.
Look, I already told you that I don't care. You decide. I've been making decisions all day.
What do you think I do all day?
I'm sorry. Me too. Well, back to the hospital.
It's open. Come in.
Hi, you cooking dinner?
That's right. Vegetables, little salad, and my specialty, fettuccine alfredo. So I hope you're hungry.
Famished.
Good.
This is a wonderful story.
Thanks.
Glad to see everything you write isn't so bleak.
Well, that's the way I am. When I'm feeling good, my characters are feeling good.
Now, when exactly did you write this?
This morning.
Tell me what's going on with you.
I know what you're talking about.
Something's going on with you.
Kate, I've met someone.
Yes?
A man.
You're having an affair. Who is it?
He's a writer. He's one of our writers.
Not the one you took to Sacramento.
He's so wonderful.
How involved are you?
Don't ask. I'm gonna see him again this afternoon.
Oh, gosh.
Hey.
What happened to your game?
Wallace canceled. How are you doing, Kate? But his wife insisted we play him doubles at their club at 3:30. I couldn't turn him down, so I set it up, you know.
I can't play this afternoon. Kate and I were going to go shopping.
Yeah.
How long does that take?
Oh, we were going to go to the city. I don't know.
I already got a babysitter.
All right, so I'll tell him that we'll meet him there at 5 o'clock. See you at 5.
Do this afternoon?
Oh, I thought I'd go out and buy a clock radio. I got to hate the sound of that alarm.
You do.
Claire, I don't want to wait until Los Angeles just so we can spend a couple of more hours together. What's wrong?
I was going to tell you that Los Angeles has been canceled.
Oh, that's great.
Jack,
that's just great.
We overbooked the show.
Claire, I'm not going to play the bad guy here. Tell you what I want. I want more time with you.
We both want the same thing.
Then take a risk.
Take a risk? I have risked my marriage as it is. What have you got to lose?
You don't get it, do you? Claire, I have fallen in love with you.
This is a cooler, but this is a classic cooler. New Sun Country Classic Wine Cooler. This tastes dry and delicious. This is dry, not delicious. This one's crystal clear. This one is not. This contains premium wine and real fruit juice. This does not. Unless you put this cooler into this cooler. Ta-ta. I was supposed to bring the cooler. You were gonna bring the chips.
You bring in the drafting table next. You know what it means to start your own business. A lot of work and some big headaches. But I don't take aspirin or Tylenol anymore. Today I take Advil. Fact is, Advil has a non-prescription strength of the medicine in the prescription brand Motrin. Doctors have already recommended Advil over 5 million times for so many types of pain. So today it's Advil. Business is tough enough. I don't want to compete with a headache. Advil. Tablets and new caplets. Advanced medicine for pain.
Taste. A flame-broiled Whopper. Double Whopper. Or Whopper Junior. The way you like it. Original. Just like you. Burger King, the best food for fast times.
Introducing the all-new, all-refreshing Irish Spring. Improved to bring more shower to your shower. Ooh, more refreshment from an all-new Irish Spring. new fragrance and skin conditioners. thicker, richer lather. The all-new, all-refreshing Irish Spring. It brings more shower to your shower.
We will return to John Bennett Perry in The Other Lover. For the next 3 weeks on Thursdays...
Complications don't end!
Television's most popular drama draws closer to its surprising season climax.
Paige, my daughter?
What happened 20 years ago?
Whatever happened doesn't make babies.
I'll take care of Peter.
I'll bet you will.
The best and the worst is yet to come on Knots Landing.
Based on a bizarre true story, a man of God, a woman of lust, his act of murder that deceives almost everyone.
I just don't believe this is an accident.
Keith Carradine, Joe Beth Williams, and Terry Kinney, Murder Ordained, Sunday on CBS.
Good evening from CBS News. This is Newsbreak. A 27-year-old American volunteer working in northern Nicaragua reportedly has been killed by American-backed Contra rebels. This from a Sandinista government spokesman who identified the victim as Benjamin Ernest Linder of Portland, Oregon. The State Department is checking the report. Independent counsel Lawrence Walsh warned Congress today that additional grants of immunity could well jeopardize his investigation into the Iran-Contra scandal.
One word distinguishes the American Express card from the others. Member. And applying for membership is easy. Just look for this display and take one.
The Reverend Jerry Falwell has cut off the $1.6 million salary of PTL leader Jim Baker and announced that the fallen preacher cannot return to power. I'm Terrence Smith, CBS News, Washington. More news later on this CBS station.
This is CBS.
Win a vacation to Walt Disney World in Long John Silver's $15 million Magic Birthday Wish Game. And you can win instantly. Then visit the Magic Kingdom and Epcot Center. It's Walt Disney World's 15th birthday. And you can win one of 100 trips there on Eastern Airlines. There's $15 million in cash and prizes. And every game card can win.
Long John Silver's.
Even yours.
Sounds good to me. Let's get excited. Oh, we just can't hide it. No, no, no. I'm about to lose control and I think I like it. I'm so excited. And I just can't hide it. No, no. I want you.
Get excited. Sign up at any Bank 4 location and get in on the run.
1,000 kids in the hospital? We'll tell you why tonight at 10.
We now return to Max Gale in The Other Lover.
Thought you had a date.
Mistresses don't have dates, Sal. They have stolen moments.
Mistresses. Mistresses also get taken care of, you know. Apartments, clothes, jewelry, dinner at Sal's. A mistress you ain't.
Whatever the hell I am, I ain't too happy about it.
Honey, I'd like a drink.
I thought you said you didn't want one.
Well, I changed my mind.
Okay. White wine?
Yes. I'll come with you.
Great. I better run the interference here. Excuse me.
Well, hello.
Hello. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Jack Hollander, this is my husband, Peter.
How do you do?
Nice to meet you.
Jack is one of our writers.
Ah. Lisa Gordon, Claire, and Peter Fielding.
Hello.
Claire. Peter.
How do you do?
I've been meaning to call you.
Really?
Your revised contracts have come up from legal, and I think you might want to take a look at them.
Well, then I'll stop by your office.
Good.
Nice to have met you.
Have a good evening.
Good night.
Good night.
See you later, Sal.
You look great out there.
Thanks. You look pretty good yourself.
Oh.
Last night.
Can you believe that? I didn't know you supported the Wiley Foundation.
I don't. Lisa does.
Oh. Is she the one that's just a friend?
That's right.
But you still go out sometimes, huh?
Mm-hmm. Claire, Lisa needed an escort, so she asked me to go with her. It's that simple. I promise. Now, do you really have contracts for me to sign? Tell the truth.
I have a meeting in Toronto on Friday.
Does that mean you're staying the weekend?
Yeah. I'm staying in a new hotel. It's one of those big mammoth structures. It's got the best French restaurant in town right next door.
Sounds great.
Gets pretty cold up there.
I bet it does.
I hope you have a warm coat.
Are you asking me to go with you? Did you already buy the tickets?
It's one in your name.
First class?
Jack Hollander, I love you so much.
What did you say?
I love you. Seems so complicated.
You think I'm making a mistake, don't you?
Well, it all sounds terribly romantic.
But you don't approve.
Claire, maybe you and Peter don't have the most passionate marriage in the world, but who does? I certainly didn't. Do you have any idea what it's like to be a single mother? I mean, it's tough.
What about the architect?
Huh.
Is he out of the picture?
Yeah.
Well, what can I bring you from Toronto?
Someone. Tall, dark, and handsome.
Why do you have to stay two nights?
Because there's a dinner tomorrow night, honey. Allison, would you get me Daddy's lint brush, please?
Mommy, there's a boy from Montreal in my class.
She's not going to Montreal.
She's going to Toronto.
I know that.
You're not taking that dress, are you?
What's wrong with it?
Well, it's got that huge slit. Plus, Mom, it leaves nothing to the imagination.
Well, I wear it here, don't I?
Yeah. But here you're with Daddy.
Hey, where is everybody?
There he is! There's Daddy! Daddy!
Hi, sweetheart. How are you doing? Huh?
What are you doing home? I thought you were working.
Hi, honey. I got the whole weekend free. I begged Morris to switch with me, and he did. I've already called the airlines. Everything is set. I'm on the flight.
What?
You know, you and I haven't had a vacation together in a long time. You know, just the two of us.
Well, I know.
It'll be a good change, don't you think?
Yeah. Huh?
Thanks a lot.
Next time we'll take you. Both of you.
But when are we gonna decorate the tree?
Right after we get back, I promise. Now, come on, help me pack, okay?
Okay.
Jack Hollander. Leave a message and I'll...
Oh. Oh, thank goodness you're home.
Looking for a barbecue sauce with a kick? Then get ready for Bullseye barbecue sauce. Its big, bold, spicy taste will put the buck in your barbecue. But first, make sure your hat's on tight. Roll up your sleeves and get yourself a firm grip, 'cause Bullseye's gonna be powerful good.
Better be ready for the big, bold taste of Bullseye barbecue sauce.
The fiber in Kellogg's Mini Wheats helps keep me flying right, but it's the delicious frosting that fuels my youthful appetite.
Small problem.
The shred of wheat nutrition gives me that drive, but the kid in me loves to tackle the tasty side.
Kellogg's Mini Wheats, shredded wheat nutrition for the adult in you. Delicious taste for that part of you that'll never grow up.
The fiber in Mini Wheats gives me a great start. When it comes to the great taste, I'm just a kid at heart.
I'll have what she's having.
Ha! Uh-huh.
Set it down gently, fellas.
That explains it, Caper.
What?
The buttery taste of your townhouse crackers. I knew there was a logical explanation.
Yes, sir. Elfin magic.
Right. That's why Keebler townhouse crackers taste so rich and buttery.
Just elfin magic.
Right. Well, I'll let you elves get back to work.
Keebler townhouse with a rich buttery taste and now low salt townhouse. Same buttery taste with only half the salt. This is the dawn of Glorious. Glorious, the joyous new fragrance by Gloria Vanderbilt. Bursting with a promise of things to come. Enter the world of Glorious by Gloria Vanderbilt. And may all your days be glorious.
Tiburon to tell me?
Yes.
You're a good friend, Kate.
So is Claire.
Max!
Wife, Kate.
Max!
The white zone is for immediate loading and unloading of passengers.
Attention, please. Announcing the arrival of Trans-Canadian Airlines Flight 416 to Toronto. Now arriving at 841 feet.
Trouble, Jack.
Really?
Any way you look at it, the woman's married.
Sal.
So my advice is you get the hell out of this.
Sal.
Before a lot of people get
Sal, hurt. I don't want to hear it.
Okay. You should put the glass down and get some sleep. I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay, we're all set. Jenny's cool and the restaurant's empty.
So we got time for a beer. You look like hell, you know that?
Stop, my timing is off. Lots of cold spots out there today.
Got nothing to do with cold spots. Not in the water, anyway. The way you're going, you might as well not bother entering the race this Saturday.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means you're starting to look like the walking wounded. You can't work, you can't sleep. Swimming time is pathetic.
Look, Sal, I need to see this thing through, okay? It's just that simple.
Let's go get a beer.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right,
come on. That's it.
Remember when Allison made this?
Yeah. And you thought you had to go to art school.
I figured that was a promise.
No. How about this one?
You told me you were going to throw that away.
Your Aunt Martha gave us
this.
That's
exactly my point.
Yeah, well, you should just be happy that it didn't multiply over the summer. His wing is broken again. But we've had it for a long time.
From the very beginning? Our first Christmas.
Yeah. So we'll just have to fix it up one more time.
No, I'm sorry. She's out. Can I tell her something for you?
She's out.
Yes.
What do you mean she's out? Let's just... Where is she, Danny?
Look, Mr. Hollander, if you want to leave a message
for
her...
No, I don't want to leave a message. Where is she?
She's shopping.
She's shopping. She's shopping at 10 o'clock in the morning?
Yes. She said she had to buy something.
Well, where is she, Danny?
I think she's at Tiffany's.
Do you have two of the same?
Just one. You.
Hello, Claire.
Hi.
And Merry Christmas.
Here.
What's this?
It's for you. Come on, open it. I know you're upset about the weekend.
It's not just the weekend. It's the whole situation. I sit at home waiting for you to call me. I'm lucky if I see you once, maybe twice a week. Half the time you have to cut it short or cancel it altogether. I'm starting to feel like a mistress.
Well, that's not fair, Jack.
Did we get off here?
Oh, you're all right. You think it's any easier for me?
Claire, this isn't a contest. I'm not saying it's any easier for you. All I know is when everything is said and done, you go home to your husband.
And you know what Peter and I talk about when I get there? We talk about the bills, the plumber, what camp the kids are going to go to. Between our children and our communities, we have no time for a relationship, Jack. It takes every ounce of energy we have just to keep things running smoothly. So we take each other for granted. The funny part about it is that it didn't seem so bad until I met you. It didn't seem...
But you did meet me, Claire. You did meet me. I can't do this, Claire.
Yes.
This isn't me.
What are you saying?
We shouldn't see one another for a while. I have this article I have to write. The holidays are coming up. We both have our commitments.
Your race is Saturday. I was planning on coming. That's such a good idea, huh? Can't we just go on? I could change things around a little. I could go to work here. I could make some more time.
Just because I'm saying there isn't enough time as is.
You want me to leave, Peter?
It's got to be your decision.
The S-Class.
What'd you think?
I think you have to sit in that big leather seat. Put Mozart, maybe Beethoven on the stereo. Then go out and drive in tight rush hour traffic. Up some back mountain road. All night in a rainstorm. And then you'll know what I think.
Which is?
I think just maybe I drove the perfect car. Or as close to it as anybody's ever come.
day of work.
Well, wish me luck.
You'll do fine.
Wanna make a good impression?
I hear there's a new kid starting today.
Oh, I hope he's cute. We're open in a few minutes,
what
sir.
What if they think it's a little late to start a new profession?
Hi, how you doing?
You got what it takes, you know it's true. Bet you'll show them the trick or two.
Let's see that three bacon, egg, and cheese biscuits, one egg McMuffin, two sausage McMuffin with egg, and one large OJ.
Are you sure you never did this before?
Thank you. Come again.
How'd it go?
I don't know how they ever got along without me.
Poison ivy, insect bites. You can count on Caladryl for relief. In fact, Caladryl can help stop almost any itch, as long as you can reach it.
Of all leading brands, only Caladryl contains Benadryl, the most recommended topical antihistamine for itch.
There's a remarkable new Coronet bath tissue. It's called Angel Soft. It's delightfully soft. It's two layers soft. In fact, it's rather amazing something so down to earth could be so soft. New Angel Soft bath tissue. It's Angel Soft. Soft.
The Other Lover, starring Lindsay Wagner, will return.
Wednesday, Heather Thomas and Ken Kirchival take on ruthless kidnappers.
They're pros.
On Hammer. Then an abandoned building becomes a death trap.
They're gonna blow this place up.
For Magnum. And
freeze, police!
Tracking a killer proves lethal for the Houston Knights. It's the legendary Gunter Gable Williams, the colossal King Tusk, those famous Ringling Clowns and more when Barbara Mandrell hosts the all-new Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus. Then, Dallas.
You're about to find out what real power can do.
The company's being dissolved.
I swear to God, I'll kill you.
What has become of this family?
In the shadow of disaster. And on Falcon Crest, betrayal.
You walked out without even a glance back.
Blackmail. And the legacy of revenge. Friday.
This is CBS.
One car is outselling all others in 1987. Ford Taurus. And your local Ford dealer has ordered a special allocation of Tauruses built just for this area. The Taurus GTS. It's equipped with air conditioning, AM/FM stereo, and more. All wrapped up in a special striping package. But with 3.9 financing or 400 cash back, you better hurry. Because even though the Taurus GTS drives like a performance car, it's priced like a family car. Ford Taurus, only while supplies last at your local Ford dealer.
Eyewitness Newsbreak, brought to you by Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Roger Cornish. On the Eyewitness Nightcast tonight, we'll have more on today's Wichita Tractorcade, including a live interview with a farmer trying to make ends meet. Also tonight, is the groundwater contamination in north central Wichita a health hazard? We'll ask the experts.
Right now, get our $2.19 Super Saver Special with two pieces of chicken, potatoes, gravy, corn, and a buttermilk biscuit. Just $2.19 now at Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Kentucky Fried Chicken, we do chicken right.
I'm Roger Cornish. Join Susan Peters and me for the Eyewitness Nightcast at 10 o'clock.
Leading in news, Sky Eye 12.
We now return to The Other Lover, starring Lindsay Wagner.
Temperature for water is a very cold 47 degrees. All other conditions are normal. Rowboats, speedboats, and kayaks will accompany the swimmers on this extremely difficult mile and a half freezing cold race. Even Daisy has arrived to give our race the seal of approval. Well, it looks like they're just about ready to start. Have a good swim, and may the best man, woman, or seal win. There are 20 swimmers entered in this year's race. Doctors, lawyers, housewives, all kinds of daring individuals are attempting to brave this 47-degree temperature. For what reason, I don't honestly know. Judd Morris, the assistant DA, and Seymour Foggy are in the lead, with Mike Garibaldi, the attorney, not far behind. Jack Hollander, the author, and Sal DiNardo are in third and fourth position. They've been at it about 15 minutes now, which means they're about halfway home. I don't know what place Daisy the Seal is in, but she's maintaining a wrecking pace. And now it's Garibaldi and Hollander fighting for the lead with Sal Dionato holding down third position. One of the swimmers looks like he's in a bit of trouble and is being pulled out of the water right in front of us.
Okay,
look how fast they do the pickup.
Hey, watch where you're going.
We're nearing the shore now, so let's remember that the record for this race was set just last year by Mike Garibaldi in 24 minutes and 10 seconds. But it doesn't look like the record will be broken this year. The race now is clearly between Garibaldi and Hollander, with Garibaldi ahead by about four strokes. There's another pickup. Another pickup. A man is down. But he is being rescued, so have no fear. Still remaining in third position is swim in this cold water is torturous, but there are at least friends and fans on shore ready and waiting to wrap the swimmers in warm blankets. And here's our winner. I think there's our winner, ladies and gentlemen. I believe it's Mike Garibaldi. It's Mike Garibaldi ahead by at least five strokes. Mike Garibaldi has not broken the record he set last year, but nevertheless has finished the race in 24 minutes. Second in 24 minutes and 34 seconds, and Sal Dionato is third in exactly 25 minutes. Isn't it amazing that these men and women have been able to do something that no prisoner in the history of Alcatraz has succeeded in doing that we know of? This is Sam Felton on the beach in front of the South Shore Swim Club, freezing cold, asking the question, why don't they swim these races in the summertime?
Okay, it's all set.
What is?
Tonight, 8 o'clock. The woman is dying to meet you.
Oh, come on, Sal.
No, you come on. She's beautiful and smart and not married.
Hey.
Hey, I want you to go home and get cleaned up and take her out and have a good time.
Okay, okay. For you, I'll do it. Let me finish my wine.
You're going to thank me.
We'll see.
Yeah.
Not only that, I got you the best table and the best restaurant in San Francisco.
They're not talking, Sal.
Well, don't worry about it. They just need time to get to know each other.
They've been sitting there for over an hour.
No, it's number 783. That's right, no. And it's the blue in the background. I just want it toned down just a little bit. Oh, no, only the background. Yes. That's it. That's the one. Okay, thank you.
I want to thank Jack Hollander for joining us today to talk about his bestseller, Boone's Point. This is Lyle Wilson saying Merry Christmas, and now, back to the music.
Boy, Jack, you were terrific.
Thanks. How's your boss doing?
Oh, she's crazed. Between trying to wrap loose ends up before the holidays and this big party tomorrow night.
Party? At the office?
No, at her house. See, she and her husband always throw this big Christmas Eve bash, and if it's any bigger than last year, they're gonna have to drop guests in by helicopter.
Okay, the extra liquor you'll find in the pantry. I'll go get... Oh. Look at you.
Thank you.
beads on everybody. Unless Maggie takes it all.
May I have another?
You got enough there, honey?
Yes.
Okay. Come on, get a plate. Better hurry up before she takes everything. Britain, huh?
Yeah.
Hi, Kate. Priscilla.
Hi.
Good to see you. John, I'm really glad you are. Dr. Mills is here. The new internist, I think we're going to...
Girls. You look so beautiful. Allison, you're lovely. Love your dress, Maggie.
Thank you.
Dashing through the snow.
You?
You do?
Yeah. I saw your picture on the back of the book. My mommy was reading it. You're a writer.
That's right. And what do you do?
I go to school.
Oh, college?
No. I'm in the seventh grade.
I bet you're a good student, too.
Everything except history.
No, I wasn't very good in history either.
Hey, you want one?
Did you eat all the caramels?
Allison, you in there?
Jack, Hollander.
Oh, right, right.
Good party.
Thanks, yeah, thanks. I just put the little one to bed.
It's great food downstairs.
Yeah, I was just on my way down. Thank you for offering me the candy.
Wait! You want the last caramel?
No. You have it. How you doing, honey? Where can we go?
Jack, why don't you come with me? Help me carry those chairs in from out back, please.
Wish you a Merry Christmas.
It's not true, Claire. I had to see you.
Jack. How do you think I've been?
Miss me?
I missed you so much.
I think she's out back.
Okay, thanks.
Eating on the run's got you tied in knots. Send the bubbles of Alka-Seltzer to the rescue. Because speed is what you need to loosen the grip of your acid indigestion and heartburn with a headache fast. So when your stomach and head have gotten you tied up, help undo it with the bubbles of Alka-Seltzer.
Alka-Seltzer to the rescue.
Try new extra strength Alka-Seltzer. More of what you take Alka-Seltzer for.
Get your spaghetti ready. Get ready for new Ragu Thick and Hearty Spaghetti Sauce. Our thickest, heartiest sauce ever. Made with lots of plump, juicy tomatoes. Special seasonings and spices for a zesty, full-bodied tomato taste. Now your spaghetti's ready. New Ragu Thick and Hearty. Our thickest, heartiest sauce ever.
Look, they're my parents, and I tell you that they're acting different. I mean, they go dancing. Herbert and Jane dancing. I know, Mother thinks it's fun. She wears eye makeup now. I don't know what's gotten into them. Whose is this? Why don't they act their age?
To help them get more out of life, people are eating better. Some have found Kellogg's Product 19, 100% of 12 vitamins and minerals. Feel good about yourself.
Tennis? They don't play tennis.
Feel like 19 again.
I love dinner parties.
You love dinner. Should country crock go here?
All that rich, buttery taste.
Or with the green beans.
Green beans?
You love green beans.
Must have been your first husband.
You are my first husband.
Shed spread country crock. Rich, buttery taste, fewer calories than regular margarine, and no cholesterol.
We're out of shed spread country crock.
Well, here's something new. Country crock and mini crock.
Same rich, buttery taste.
Mm-hmm, and a third fewer calories, too.
Hey, that's two good reasons to eat country crock.
In two adorable new mini crocks.
Looks like they were made for each other.
Uh-huh, another perfect couple.
Uh-huh.
And now, the conclusion of The Other Lover, starring Jessica Lea.
I'd better go.
please listen to me.
No, just go away. I don't want to talk to you. I don't ever want to talk to you again.
All right, then don't you talk. I'll talk. Just hear me out. Honey, I love you very, very much. And I love your father.
You're lying.
I wouldn't do anything in the world to hurt either one of you.
Yes, you would! Because you did! I mean, I saw you were there kissing
him! Allison, I know what you're thinking.
No! You know, you think that I'm just a little girl and you can say anything and I believe you.
I don't. I know you're not a little girl anymore. That's why we have to talk this out. Honey, you're cold.
I can take care of myself.
Go home.
You hungry?
No.
I think I'll fix you an omelet.
Sal. It's Christmas Day. Go home to your wife.
You don't have to worry about Jenny. She sent me over here.
Not knowing is, it's driving me crazy.
Well, is she gonna call you as soon as she can?
Allison? Honey, open the door, please.
Go away!
Allison, open up the door, please.
What's going on? Is Allison sick?
Honey, open the door.
Allison, are you okay?
I'm tired.
Well, we're going down to open presents. Anyone who's late has got to wait till next year.
Okay, Daddy.
Merry Christmas, honey.
Merry Christmas, Daddy. Come on.
You coming, honey?
Sure. I'll start the eggnog.
That sounds great. I could use some eggnog. She must be afraid Maggie's going to open all the presents. This should be a family outing.
You know Mommy doesn't skate.
I could watch, I suppose.
Only if you promise not to laugh at me as I go sliding across the ice on my gluteus maximus.
I don't even know where my park is. That's all right.
Mother? It's in the downstairs closet.
Well, then I'll get it.
Fielding, what is it with you and my bumper?
gonna take some time, I think.
She won't tell Peter?
No.
What about you? Will you tell Peter?
I can't.
I was afraid of that.
I wish I could help you understand that.
What's it understand? I'm at the right woman at the wrong time. Smart of her, was it?
No, it wasn't.
Well, I guess it's time to ring out the old year. I can't believe I'm never going to see you again.
Don't say that, Jack. Please.
It's the truth. It's the truth. Funny how easily we set up the rules of the game and how easily we break them, even with the best of intentions. I didn't call Claire and she didn't call me. After a while, I started writing a new novel. The months went by, but I still couldn't find an ending.
Business?
Oh, busy, busy, busy. You still swimming?
Oh, yeah, and I finally won.
Really? Well, that's wonderful. When?
March.
Oh, well, we should have a drink to celebrate that.
Sure.
Tully's?
Tomorrow? 7?
Okay. Your food's getting cold. Nice to see you, Jack.
Good to see you too, Claire. Tomorrow, then?
$2. called Tully's Grill, just in case she was waiting for me. They said she had already called to cancel. Well, I finally had an ending to my book.
Tomorrow, author Dominic Dunn and Massachusetts Governor Michael Dukakis will tell us why he wants to be president. That's tomorrow on the morning program.
Based on a bizarre true story, a man of God.
Divorce is impossible.
A woman of lust. His act of murder. Unholy alliance.
Pray's kill.
Pray.
That deceives almost everyone.
I just don't believe this is an accident.
Now, what are you trying to say? I didn't do my job?
Keith Carradine, Joe Beth Williams, and Terry Kinney as Pastor Tom Bird, Murder Ordained.
Sunday on CBS.